liver disease with pregnancy, classification of liver pregnancy, pre-existing liver disease, present throughout pregnancy, and can have a variable course from patient to patient, chronic hepatitis B and C, autoimmune hepatitis, Wilson's disease, primary biliary cirrhosis, primary sclerosing cholangitis, cirrhosis due to any cause. These diseases are pre-existing before pregnancy. Liver diseases related to pregnancy only, hyperemesis gravidarum, HELLP syndrome, intrahepatic biliary cholestasis of pregnancy, acute fatty liver of pregnancy. Liver disease coincidental to pregnancy, acute viral hepatitis, but all types, A, B, C, gallstones, Bocciriani syndrome, drug-induced hepatotoxicity, sepsis. Liver disease unique to pregnancy, which occurs only during pregnancy. Of course, it changes of the liver during severe hyperemesis gravidarum and HELLP syndrome, which have been studied before in separate lectures. But here we will study intrahepatic biliary cholestasis of pregnancy and pregnancy. Intrahepatic pregnancy incidence 1.2 to 1.5% of all pregnancies. Pathophysiology, it is a defect of excretion of bile salts, risk factors or pre-disposing factors, high level of estrogen, which occurs during pregnancy as a physiological changes, genetic predisposition runs in females of certain families, advanced maternal age and old age, and presentation and the clinical picture start on second or third trimester by pruritus. Severe pruritus, which should be the differential diagnosed from or recognized from scales, jaundice in less than 25% of cases, usually after pruritus, fatigue, anorexia, and investigations. Serum bile acid during fasting is more than 10 micromole per liter, amino transferase mild increase to 10 to 25 times normal. Total bilirubin is increased but less than 6 mg per deciliter. Alkaline phosphatase up to 4 times the normal. Liver biopsy not indicated, but if we did it, centriglobular cholestasis is present without inflammation, and the bile blobs is present in the hepatocyte and the canal. Treatment, low fat intake. Also, deoxycholic acid, 500 mg to 1.5 grams daily, a divided dose on 3 doses, 3 times daily with meals. Euros, deoxycholic acid relieves the pruritus and improves liver test abnormalities. Cholestyramine and dexamethasone can be given, antihistamines, vitamin K, and other fat soluble vitamins, supplementation. Alternate treatment is delivery. Not more than 37 weeks of gestation should be. Maternal risk after delivery, increased incidence of gallstones, cholestasis, pancreatitis, recurrence in subsequent pregnancy. Acute fatty liver of pregnancy, incidence 1 to 7,000 to 1 to 20,000 of pregnancy. It's rare. Bad prognosis for both mother and fetus. Increased maternal mortality rate to 10 to 20 times the normal pregnancy, while the parent mortality rate increased also to 20 to 30 times of normal. Previous both the boy, primary gravida, male, the patient is pregnant in male fetus, as male fetus, multiple pregnancy. Clinical picture, it occurs after 30 weeks and usually near to 36 to 37 weeks. Clinical picture in the form of nausea, anorexia, and malaise. Also severe vomiting, abdominal pain, epigastric pain, mild preeclampsia may be present, jaundice, and it has liver if we look at liver function, there is increase in the 3 to 10-fold elevation in the transaminase level, with alkaline phosphatase, permanent liver failure, and hepatic encephalopathy. 90% of patients chose DIC, disseminated intravascular coagulopathy. Renal impairment is common, hypoglycemia, and 70% of cases urea. Investigations, lab investigations, high bilirubin, high ammonia, high lactic acid, normal platelet count, which can be used to differentiate it between it and the health syndrome, low albumin, low glucose level, and low fibrinogen level, low prothrombin time, elevated of course liver enzymes, and there's the renal function up to radiological, MRI, CT, or ultrasonography doesn't show any abnormal picture for the liver, except sometimes the ultrasonography show the liver bright in color and the presence of effects in capillary cavity. Liver biopsy not necessary due to presence of GRC and coagulopathy, but if done, it will show microvesicular fatty infiltration of hepatocytes, little or no inflammation or hepatocellular necrosis. Management of acute fatty liver with pregnancy delivery is the ultimate treatment for the case. Especially it occurs late in pregnancy, so we can't wait one day after definite diagnosis for the treatment, for the disease. The delivery will improve the maternal and fetal prognosis. Coagulopathy and hypoglycemia must be treated before delivery by infusion of 50% glucose, infusion of fresh frozen plasma and albumin, plasma fluorescence, in acetylcysteine, antioxidant, ventilation and devices in ZRT. Respiratory diseases with pregnancy. Bronchial asthma is the most common respiratory disease with pregnancy. The incidence is 8% of all pregnancy. Complications of bronchial asthma. Pregnancy induced hypertension and preeclampsia, intrauterine growth restriction and low birth weight. Acute severe attacks in the first trimester are associated with higher rate of congenital fetal malformations. Management as non-pregnant patients. Tuberculosis increase the chance of the newly infected during TB patient during the pregnancy. If the patient has positive family history or has positive past history of TB. Treatment similar to non-pregnant TB patients. Breastfeeding is not contraindicated as the patient is under treatment. Pneumonia is one of the common causes of mortality, one of the causes of mortality of the pregnant female. Most common organism is Streptococcus pneumonia, Haemophilus influenza, Mycoplasma pneumonia, and COVID-19, especially in this syndrome. If a chest X-ray or CT are needed, abdominal chills must be put on. Neurological disorders. Classifications: pre-existing disorders, epilepsy, migraine, myasthenia gravis, and multiple sclerosis. Which are new onset disorders: pre-eclampsia, eclampsia, cerebral venous thrombosis, cerebral hemorrhage, and vernix in cavalry. Of course, pre-eclampsia and eclampsia are known for the pregnant female. Cerebral venous thrombosis, cerebral hemorrhage, and vernix in cavalry occurs incidentally or coincidentally with pregnant patient. Epilepsy, pre-existing neurological disease during pregnancy, its incidence is 0.5% of all pregnancies which are complicated with epilepsy. Maternal complication of epileptic seizures during epileptic seizure during pregnancy will lead to lactic acidosis, transient condition of blood pressure, increased intra-abdominal pressure, redistribution of the blood flow to the brain and the muscles, with consequent decrease in the blood flow to the viscera and uterus. Of course, the fetus may be affected, especially if the seizure it has long time, because there is decrease in the placenta uterine circulation to the fetus will be affected. The effect and risk of seizures during labor is 9 times more than that during pregnancy. Fetal complications of epileptic seizures. Perinatal mortality increased 1.2 to 3 times higher. Stillbirth, prematurity, perinatal death, congenital anomalies associated especially due to anti-epileptic drugs if more than one drug is taken, intracranial hemorrhage. management during pregnancy, single antiepileptic drugs should be used, regular estimation of maternal serum level of antiepileptic agents, sleeping time must not be less than 8 hours at night, folic acid supplementation before and early in pregnancy is advised. Management of seizures during the pregnancy. The patient should be put on left lateral position to increase the uterine blood flow and prevent aspiration pneumonia. Oxygen inhalation. Lorazepam 2 mg intravenously repeated every 5 times till the seizure stops. Diazepam 5 to 10 mg alternative and the termination of pregnancy of course. Migraine, it is a vascular headache due to cerebral vasodilatation. It starts as ball aching headache, then pulsating pain in the temples, frontal bone, or the base of the skull. Nausea and vomiting and visual disturbance are common. Management, advise the patient to start non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs as early as possible once the migraine attacks. Tylenol 500 mg. 2 pills every 6 hours, caffeine and anti-emetic drugs from maybe myasthenia gravis. It is an autoimmune neurovascular disease leading to weakness, fatigue of the skeletal muscles all over the body. Exacerbation of symptoms are most likely to occur in the first trimester only or just after the delivery. Transient perinatal myasthenia gravis occurs 10 to 20% of cases. Neonatal develops respiratory problems, muscle weakness, poor suckling, and tosis. Management, acetylcholine esterase inhibitors, pyridoxastamine, and neostigmine. Corticosteroid vaginal delivery is preferable, but it may need vacuum extraction or low forceps to minimize time of the second stage of labor. Cesarean section performed only for obstetric causes. Multiple sclerosis is a disease in the central nervous system, characterized by both neuroinflammation or neuroinflammation and neurodegeneration. The risk of relapse is reduced during pregnancy. If relapse occurs, its treatment as non-wet film. It is the most sensitive and specific diagnosis to test for bacterial vaginosis, done by adding equivalent amount of vaginal discharge to saline on a slide test under and examined under light microscope. Flue cells will be seen. Flue cells are epithelial cells covered by coccobacillus. Infections of bacterial vaginosis and most of the inflammation during pregnancy will lead to these complications due to release of prostaglandins, which will stimulate the uterine contraction. It will lead to miscarriage or preterm labor, erosion of the back or forward erosion of the amniotic membrane, which lead to premature rupture of membrane, determined premature rupture of membrane, a secondary infection leading to chorioamnionitis, post-abortal sepsis, bacteremia, postpartum endometritis, and post-cesarean section wound infection, micronidazole or metronidazole. Trichomonas vaginalis, it is a protozoal infection of the urogenital fluid. The infection is not increased during pregnancy. Clinical manifestation, 1/3 of patients are asymptomatic. Vaginal discharge is yellow-greenish in color, itchy, frothy, and full smelling. Lower abdominal pain, redness, swollen, hotness of the vulva, vagina, and cervix may be observed. Diagnosis, vaginal discharge can be examined directly for trichomonas. Also, urethral discharge if urethritis is present. Culture if direct microscopy is negative. Complications, miscarriage, preterm labor, premature preterm membrane, and low birth weight. Treatment, metronidazole 200 mg
3 times a day for 7 days, not in the first trimester. Local myconazole vaginal cream should be used twice daily. The husband should be treated also. Familial vaginitis candida albicans is a causative organism. It occurs in high acidic pH of the vaginal secretion. As the high estrogen level during pregnancy, the high epithelial glycogen secreted, so it is the source of nutrition for the fungus. Clinical manifestation: itching, cheesy, scanty vaginal discharge, burning sensation with micturition, scratch marks, and the alteration of the vulva, white patches on the wall of the vagina. Treatment: local antifungal as myconazole vaginal cream at bedtime for at least 7 days. Genital warts caused by human papilloma virus 6 or 11, usually asymptomatic. The shape of the warts flat, pedunculated or cauliflower. Sites of the warts: cervix, vagina, around introitus, urethra or perineum. Treatment is by removal of the warts, but not during pregnancy, because it will not be perfectly removed during pregnancy and recurrence will occur definitely. Effect of warts on pregnancy: human papilloma virus causes respiratory papillomatosis of the neonate for unknown cause or unknown mechanism. Genital displacement, retroverted gravid uterus, genital prolapse. Retroverted gravid uterus is either pre-existing or may be due to pregnancy. It leads to incarceration of the gravid uterus. Anatomical changes following incarceration: it occurs in the uterus, urethra, and the bladder. Anatomical uterine changes during incarceration. Cervix is directed upward and forward. Rarely, the uterus continues to expand throughout anterior wall, leading to anterior circulation, or through the posterior wall, leading to posterior circulation. Urethral changes: marked elongation with the base of the bladder due to stretching of the anterior vaginal wall by the cervix. Urine retention due to mechanical compression of the urethra by the cervix, or edema of the bladder neck. Bladder changes as a result of retention of urine: the bladder distends up to the umbilicus. In cases of continuous retention of urine, the bladder will become thickened due to edema. Severe cystitis, pyelonephritis, intraperitoneal rupture of the bladder. In severe cases, obstructive nephrectomy may occur. Effect of incarceration on pregnancy: miscarriage, anterior circulation, malpresentation, non-engagement of the preventing cord, preterm delivery, and prematurity, rupture of the uterus may occur. Genital prolapse in pregnancy. Pregnancy may occur in cases of first degree uterine prolapse with cystocele and rectocele, but rarely to occur when the cervix remains outside the introitus due to changes in the cervix that makes the cervical discharge or cervical secretions are hostile to the sperm. Complications on pregnancy: miscarriage, discomfort, preterm premature rupture of membrane, and chorioamnionitis. On labor: early rupture of the membranes, cervical dystocia, prolonged labor due to non-dilatation of the cervix and cervical dystocia, obstruction due to sagging, the cystocele or rectocele. On peridium, sub-involution of the uterus, uterine bacterial infection. Neoplasms: we will study cervical common neoplasms during pregnancy, cervical polyps, leiomyomas, and cervical carcinomas. Cervical polyp, whether as a result of pregnancy or pre-existing with pregnancy, they bleed easily due to increased vasculature during pregnancy. The bleeding may be mistaken with other causes of bleeding with pregnancy. The polyp must be removed and sent for histopathological study. Leiomyoma with pregnancy is usually a conservative treatment, like rest in bed, analgesics if needed, a good diet, The only stage in which we can interfere is the red degeneration. They may be up to surgical interference to treat the red degeneration. But all of these can be treated. All the other types of leiomyoma can be wait till after delivery and even not removed by myomectomy during cesarean section, because it's very dangerous for the excessive bleeding and may lead to complications as up to death of the patient. Cervical carcinoma with pregnancy incidence is 1 in 2,500 pregnant patients. Diagnosis bleeding with pregnancy should be differential diagnosed, should be recognized from other causes of bleeding during pregnancy. If carcinoma is suspected, biopsy from the lesion is a must and central. Effect of pregnancy on cervical carcinoma increases the rate of spread after abortion or vaginal delivery. Effect of carcinoma on pregnancy, abortion, preterm labor, secondary cervical dysplasia, injury of the cervix and the lower uterine segment causing the postpartum hemorrhage, pyometria of anduterine sepsis. Also, management of carcinoma of the cervix during pregnancy is depending on degree or stage of the carcinoma of cervix, and also depending on the present time of pregnancy, first or second or third trimester, and the treatment of and the management of carcinoma of cervix is sufficiently discussed in case or in gynecology in lecture of carcinoma of cervix. Thank you.